Este día tengo que beberme, aunque sea un tequila entero.
Para aguantarme.
Oye, oye, necesito de todo.
Hey. Hi.
Hi.
How y'all doing?
Good.
Oh, what y'all doing? Just having pizza.
Yes, you want some pizza?
She told me that she wanna come and hang out with us to go to drink. I said, okay, you coming? But I never believed that she want to come to drink with us, for real. But, like, she can't. So, like, I'm a little nervous this thing can go wrong when she tried to talking, because she can say that she tried to come and make an effort, but I never believe that she coming to make an effort.
Can you give me an introduction to your friends?
You know all of them.
But I'm here to get to know your friends a little bit better.
You know all of them.
Is this y'all's table too, or are y'all here?
No, we have a table too.
Yeah, we're sitting. Want
to sit? Sure, I'll have a drink.
So let me introduce you. This is Yearly.
Yeah.
This is Chantel. Ella es la esposa de Pedro. Mm-hmm. Okay. This is Eric.
I remember you.
That's Santo.
Hi.
That's Nydia.
Yeah, I remember. Like, I know everybody.
Yeah, she know everybody.
Yeah. Yeah, I know everybody.
When she walk in the room with attitude, you know, like introduce me with your friends, you know what I mean? Like that was triggering me like that, because I say, oh my God, you know my friends already. I introduced to them, you know, like, it's not your first time. Those are the people that you've been talking they you say that I've been spending time, that we're cheating, you know, those are the people, and you don't know them. You know, like, that take me out, you know, out of the move right away.
I just wanted to come here to get to know Pedro's coworkers more, because he always is with you guys. You know, he's with the coworkers more than he's at home. So I want to get to know his friends and, like...
I need one more, please.
Like, I kind of leave work at work. But since y'all are his friends...
Yeah, we're like a family.
Yeah. So I want to get to know you on a friendly basis. So that when...
And you need to come out more.
Well, I don't always get the invitation.
I think Chantel just wanted to come and, I guess, see what Pedro was up to. When she walked in, I could definitely feel the tension because of the way that he was looking at her. You know, like, what are you doing here type of thing? Instead of saying, hey, you're here, that's great, come enjoy, maybe. Pedro is very private about his life at home, and I respect that. But it was tense.
It's not even like that I need to always be there, which I don't feel like I need to. It's just like, I never know where he is. You're making it seem like you're doing things that I don't believe you would do.
That you're thinking, that you do things that you
no.
do not.
No, you, because that... when I ask you what you're doing, you tell me it's none of my business. And then there's a game of ownership that he tells me that you guys play at the office.
What's that?
A game of ownership.
Yeah.
So he came home with his key fob, and it had Antonella's name on it. And I said, Pedro, what's this? And he said, it's a little game we play at the office. And I say, Pedro, why you come home with another lady's name on your key fob?
You guys can definitely talk about this. You know, when we work.
Yeah, and
I understand where you're coming from.
I do
want to
know about the game of ownership, Antonella.
So we were
What was the game? Like, explain to me the rules and. Well,
remember the day? You were there, no?
Yeah, I put in my computer, Pedro.
Yeah.
In the door, Pedro. But this is just playing.
Right.
Okay. He's my friend. It's...
Like, I think it was just one day that I took a stapler off of his desk, and then he started labeling everything on his desk Pedro, even though the stapler wasn't even his in the first place.
Do you see how that could kind of get, like, how it could get a rise out of me if he brought that home?
All I know is there's a woman at his job that sent him home with her name on his keys. They're hanging out with him, and they don't care to ask me if I want to come. I was trying to meet Pedro halfway and go to the bar with him and his friends. And when he greeted me cold and acted like he wanted nothing to do with me, I lost control. He treats me like I'm nothing at home, but to do it in front of his peers was a different level of betrayal.
Mm-hmm.
I don't disagree with going to the bar, but things got bad really fast. It took a wrong turn when I opened up about my personal problems with Pedro in front of his coworkers. That was completely out of line, and everything was out of control.
I wanted to come and meet with you and your friends because I wanted to get to know your friends better. I didn't mean to.
You mean to do that?
No, I didn't.
Wow, why you don't mean to do that? Like, why? When you take all the laundry things, the problem that we had, you throw in front of everybody.
Because when you know, I came there, I thought you were going to be happy to see me. And then when you were not happy to see me, the look in your eyes really
It was something about
the look in your eyes
was so mean to me.
No, it doesn't matter.
Okay, you tried to blame on me.
I'm not trying to blame you. But you told all your friends bad things about us.
When?
You did.
When?
You told me that you were going to tell everybody in the office all about our business.
No, you imagine things right now. That's you, okay?
But it's your fault.
Okay, you see that, okay? It's my fault. Look, everything related to my fault, no?
So far.
So far, okay, perfect. Like,
I'm only asking for you to tell
me.
Why are you cutting me off and I let you talk?
Yeah, but I don't.
I let you talk all the time.
Talk.
I only want for you to be nice. And I only want for you to give me love.
Yeah, but how the way I go all the time give you love if you all the time think that I'm cheating? That I'm playing my game to you all the time. They always want to you make angry. How I can give you that if all the time you think it's only bad thing about me all the time? With Chantel, and to the point, they can't win with her. I don't know how to make her happy no longer. All these years, I tried to make her happy. You know, give her what she wants, you know, all that she needs. That she can be happy for me, you know, for my goals, you know, for my dreams, you know, like, yes. That's it. I don't want to fight no more.
So what are you gonna do?
Move out, that's it.
You're gonna move out. I didn't say that I wanted you to move out, so what makes you think that you want to move out?
Because I make you happy.
Well, that's gonna make me even more unhappy if you move out. Where are you gonna go?
I don't know yet. I'm going to stay here as long as I need to find an apartment or something.
That's the first step to divorce Pedro.
Pedro has never said that he's wanted a separation before. It's hard to hear the words coming out of his mouth. It feels unreal.
You go upstairs?
You can go upstairs. I'll go to take some time in my car.
I don't want this. This is the worst thing that could ever happen. I want my marriage. I love my husband. I don't agree with this.